G'day, I'm Hans. Now, have you ever wondered why your car works or why the walls don't fall down when you're trying to take a shower? Well, it's all thanks to engineers. They're the ones responsible for everything from your toaster to the skyscrapers in the city. And today, thanks to Student Edge, we're here at Australia's newest airport terminal, the new domestic terminal in Perth. We're going to talk to a real-life structural engineer and find out what the whole thing is all about. Engineering is a very important job in today's world, but there isn't just one type of engineer. There are mechanical engineers, structural, electrical, civil, military, mining, and heaps of other types, all of who make stuff work.
Hans!
And how are you?
Good, thanks. It's lovely to meet you.
You too. I've got some questions about being an engineer. Can you help me?
Absolutely. Come inside, I'll answer all your questions.
Let's do it.
With me, take a seat.
Thank you.
So, what would you like to know?
Oh, I want to know where you get your wardrobe from. No, I want to know all about what we're doing here in the brand new Perth Domestic Airport Terminal. That's where all the noise is happening.
So, we're here today to have a look at the new domestic airport. It's for fly-in, fly-out workers predominantly, and it should be finished soon. So it's pretty exciting.
And you're here because you're an engineer.
Absolutely, yes. I work in construction, so there are lots of different types of engineers. There's design and construction. Design does the calculations to identify what sort of structure will work, and the construction engineer makes sure that what's designed is built correctly.
Well, look, I'm pretty blown away by this place, but when you first started, this would have just been dirt.
Absolutely. It's pretty rewarding seeing the site just from a big pile of dirt and a bit of concrete on the ground to the building that it is today with a full baggage handling system and security system and everything.
Do you come here every day? I mean, what's a typical day for you? Tell me about what you do.
So I come to work. I wake up at about 5:30 in the morning, get here 6:30 to 7, and then I start at the computer and I check what needs to be completed in the day, and then I come out to site, make sure that I have my phone with me because I'll probably be ringing up people and saying, why haven't you done this?
You got to be the boss lady.
Yeah.
That's awesome. All right, Anne, it's that time. I need you to give me the edge.
All right.
Okay with that?
Yeah.
Here we go. First question first. If I want to be an engineer, what do I have to do to become one?
First, I'd recommend seeing your careers guidance counsellor at school. I'd recommend studying maths as well as chemistry and physics, and then studying engineering at uni might be a good idea.
Full on nerd load, sweet. Second question is, what sort of person is best suited to being an engineer? I'm assuming good at maths has got to be one of them.
Absolutely, aptitude with maths is right up there, as well as good communication skills, works well in a team, and also a good problem solver, because you come across some difficult problems and you also need persistence in resolving those problems.
And finally, if you could have done one thing differently but still ended up, you know, exactly where you are today, what would you have done better?
Well, I would have been a bigger nerd and stayed at uni for longer. I would have probably done a master's because that just opened up a lot more doors internationally and within Australia.
Well, certainly seems like nerds have the most fun. Anne, thank you so much for showing
Cheers.
Us around.
Good to meet you.
All right, can I keep all this?
Absolutely.
All right. Yeah, it's constructed real good. Hey, if you're keen on being an engineer, remember that there are all sorts of different types of engineers, and you've got to talk to real life ones to find out the one that you want to do. And remember what Anne said, don't be afraid of talking to your career guidance counsellor at school. If you want more information or you want to get involved, jump on to studentedge.com.au. Sorry, got to go find the rest of the village people.